Understanding other standards that add value to carbon credits. Hi, and welcome to the next video in the PERL Eco Education series on the carbon markets. In the previous video, we looked at some of the different standards for issuing carbon credits. In this video, we'll continue looking at the different mechanisms that can drive additional value to carbon credits. In our previous video, we hinted that understanding CCB accreditation would be a topic we would look at another time. In the context of carbon projects, CCB stands for the Climate, Community, and Biodiversity Standards. The CCB standards is a set of guidelines and criteria developed by the Climate, Community, and Biodiversity Alliance to assess and certify projects that simultaneously address climate change, support local communities, and conserve biodiversity. The CCB standards aim to ensure that carbon projects go beyond the mere reduction of greenhouse gas emissions and also deliver additional social and environmental benefits. These standards provide a framework for project developers to design and implement projects that not only mitigate climate change, but also promote sustainable development and conservation efforts. The importance of CCB in driving value in carbon credits lies in the additional benefits it brings to the project. By adhering to the CCB standards, carbon projects can demonstrate their commitment to environmental and social responsibility, which enhances their overall value and market appeal, as these additional benefits appeal to corporations who are often the end customers for carbon credits. There are several key reasons why CCB is important for driving value in carbon credits, such as environmental co-benefits where CCEB-certified projects meet stringent biodiversity conservation criteria, which often involve preserving or restoring ecosystems, protecting endangered species, and promoting sustainable land use practices. These environmental co-benefits add value to carbon credits by demonstrating the project's positive impact on ecosystems and the natural world, which benefit the global economy by trillions of dollars each year. CCB-certified projects also emphasize the importance of local communities and their involvement in project activities. They aim to enhance livelihoods, improve social well-being, and foster community engagement. By supporting local communities, carbon projects can generate positive social impacts, such as job creation, income generation, improved access to clean energy or clean water, and capacity building. In our previous video, we referenced that poverty can be one of the most significant contributors to deforestation, which is why these communities are so important in protecting the environment. Poverty reduction, access to clean water, and the empowerment of women and girls are all important United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs. Buying carbon credits and supporting these social outcomes allows companies to claim support for these SDGs in their corporate responsibility reporting, which again can enhance the value of carbon credits. Some corporations with ambitious sustainability goals or governments implementing carbon offset programs may specifically seek CCB-certified credits. These buyers are willing to pay a premium for credits that align with their broader sustainability objectives. By meeting the CCB standards, carbon projects can access these premium markets, potentially commanding higher prices for their credits. In our PERL Eco Carbon Market Education series, we have explained why not all carbon credits are the same. These standards and different approaches to emissions avoidance and sequestration really matter to end users who typically consider several key factors to ensure that the credits align with their sustainability goals and provide the desired environmental impact. These are the factors to assess when considering whether a carbon project is likely to deliver high-value carbon credits or not. Buyers prioritize carbon credits that are certified and verified by recognized standards and third-party organizations. These certifications provide assurance that the credits have undergone a rigorous assessment and meet specific criteria for credibility and environmental integrity. As we learned previously, commonly recognized standards include the Verified Carbon Standard and Gold Standard, as well as some smaller standards such as the American Carbon Registry and the Climate Action Reserve. Additionality is one of the most important factors for end customers of carbon credits. It refers to the concept that carbon credits represent emission reductions or removals that would not have occurred without financial support from the buyer. Buyers want to ensure that the projects they support are genuinely additional, meaning they go beyond business-as-usual activities and make a real impact on reducing emissions. We previously looked at several different approaches to carbon projects. Buyers may have preferences for specific project types or locations based on their sustainability priorities. For example, some buyers may focus on renewable energy projects, while others may be interested in reforestation or community-based initiatives. The geographic location of the project can also be a factor, as buyers may want to support projects in regions where they have a presence or where environmental challenges are particularly pressing. Buyers will typically assess the environmental impact of carbon credits by evaluating the emission reductions or removals achieved by the project. They may consider the number of carbon credits available for purchase, the longevity and permanence of the emission reductions, and the project's contribution to global climate goals. Buyers often look for projects that can demonstrate significant and measurable environmental benefits. These may include the preservation of biodiversity, but also support for local communities, sustainable development, improved livelihoods, or the advancement of sustainable practices. Projects that can demonstrate positive co-benefits alongside carbon mitigation often have higher appeal to buyers. Finally, transparency and traceability are important for buyers to understand the project's methodology, monitoring, and verification processes, as well as the chain of custody for the credits. Transparency helps ensure the credibility and integrity of the credits and allows buyers to communicate the environmental impact to stakeholders effectively. This is an area where blockchain technologies can make a significant contribution to driving greater integrity in the voluntary carbon markets, but that is a topic that we will cover another time. But for now, thank you for watching this latest episode from the PERL Eco Carbon Markets Education Series. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to be notified when our next video is available. Until next time.